Tennessee. A lot of haters out there, a lot of haters. So much so, as I told you guys last week, and it's only continued, and these are the first times in my life that these accusations have been thrown at me, I have been labeled. I'm talking about stamped to the forehead. There's a lot of room there, as you can see. Tennessee homer. Colin Bell knows good and well that that's false. But yet, I have been labeled a Tennessee homer. There's, out of the two of us that's in this building right now, one of us pulls into the parking lot every day with a Tennessee plate on the front of our car. And it's not me, but yet I've been labeled. Here's what I'm not going to do with this whole Tennessee segment we're about to talk about for a few minutes. There are a lot of very tired go-to takes, arguments, whichever verbiage you want to use there, for Tennessee's pretty hot recruiting stretch now. It's not a start. It's been a stretch. All of May, they've been hot. And so you've got the usual detractors that come in, and a lot of them will point out the average star ranking is not on par with what Ohio State has or maybe some of the other big boys. And then the others will tell you, well, hey, it's only May, so there's a lot of time for these kids to decommit. And then you've got the, well, who cares? Tennessee got talent under Butch Jones. Who says they're going to win now? I don't buy into any of that, so I'm not going to waste a whole lot of time with that. I mean, those arguments are low-hanging fruit. They're a dime a dozen. I'm not saying they couldn't end up being true. I just don't particularly buy into any of those lines of thought. So I want to talk tonight about what you guys are quietly whispering, a lot of you, amongst yourselves. A lot of you are very loudly shouting what I just went down a list of. Quietly, what you're doing is you're saying, how in the world is Tennessee doing this, though? Like, what approach is Jeremy Pruitt using? What messaging is he getting across to these kids that makes them commit to Tennessee and want to play for Tennessee, a place that hasn't proven in a program, hadn't proven they can do anything in almost a generation now? And not only that, they're getting kids that also have offers from other major programs. How are they doing this? How in the world is Jeremy Pruitt doing this? What is he selling? Well, I think I know, and I cheat because I get to talk to some of these kids, but he's selling vision. Now, I don't want to rehash old thoughts here, but we have new viewers every show and every week, and I appreciate it. I love having you guys. Can't wait till the season starts. We're going to blow it out of the water, viewership-wise, when the season gets here. But this is all that's happening. Last year, they had a horrific start, and then they steadied things, and then they were able, outside of your view, because you weren't paying attention to Tennessee, they ran off a string of wins at the end of the year. It wasn't a big deal. They didn't beat any top five team, but they ran off a string of wins. Salvaged their season, got to bowl eligibility, went and beat Indiana, I think it was, Colin. Yeah, Indiana and Jacksonville. Not anything to write home about. You didn't care if you just care about your team and the national scene. That was very much outside of your purview. But if you're watching the YouTube feed right now, you see Jeremy Pruitt. What he was able to do, what that man was able to do, is he was able to take it, and he was able to go into enough living rooms and say, you saw how we started, but you also saw how we finished. Now, how we finished, that's a preview of what I think this program is going to be under my leadership and direction moving forward, but we need you. And he got enough of those yous to wrap up a top 10 class this last cycle, which I thought was a borderline miracle that was worked by that coaching staff. So then we fast forward a little bit further. Now, there haven't been any more games played between now and then, but they're off to a really hot start in recruiting. That's all they're selling, guys. He is able to convince, over the voices of all the detractors and maybe negative recruiters that have sat in these kids' living rooms and pitched against Tennessee, he's been able to overcome enough of that and convince kids, I've got a track record, okay? We may not have won big here yet, but look where I've been. We won big when I was at Alabama the first time and the second time. We won at Florida State. We won at Georgia. I've won everywhere I've been. I don't know how to lose once we get an adequate roster. I gotta have you. I'm Jeremy Pruitt right now. I gotta have you, okay? You want me to show you how I can develop you? Here it is. You want me to show you I know how to evaluate talent? Here's who I've gotten in the past. I got all these boxes checked. Look on my mantle here. Those are my championship rings. I got all that. I've been there. We need to get there here, and I need you to help me. The finish in 2019 was the key. But I'll tell you this. In 2020, I think it was to wrap up the last edition of Late Kick Live we had, someone asked. I think it was a guy named Dylan watches the program, and he asked, all these big games Tennessee has coming up in 2020, are there any must-win games? And he cited Oklahoma, Florida, Georgia, Alabama. Those are the four biggest games, I'll say, for Tennessee this year. And I think unequivocally the answer is yes. Because here's the problem. You can only sell a vision for so long. You can only sell hope for so long. So I just took the role of Jeremy Pruitt, but now if I take the role of an assistant coach from Georgia or from Florida or from Alabama, and I'm in your living room, and Tennessee strikes out again this year, and they're sitting there again 7-5 and or 6-6, whatever the case may be, and they've been blown out by the four big boy legitimate national championship contending teams they play, I'm going to tell you point blank, how many more years do you have to see this? Like, if I'm Florida, we just, I don't know what we did in 2020, but I assume Florida's going to be pretty good again this year. If I'm Bama, if I'm LSU, if I'm Clemson, we have once again been in the national championship picture. Like, there's no mystery here, kid. We're there every year. They're there never. Do you know how old you were the last time we mentioned Tennessee football and college football playoff? Well, we never have, because it didn't exist the last time that they were a contender at the end of the year. You only get one college career. Do you really want to flush it down the toilet taking a chance in Knoxville? When we're proven, we already know, we already got the formula. Let's just plug you in and go with what you know works in Gainesville, in Tuscaloosa, in Athens. That's how quickly things can change. That's what could upset this recruiting class, if you're talking about potentially upsetting it. I think they're on a pretty good roll right now. I don't have any reason to believe a bunch of these kids are going to decommit, but I think it is critically important for them to win at least one of these big games. Get one of those sometimes overhyped, but in this case, I think very properly hyped program-defining wins. Jeremy Pruitt's going to need one this year. You can only sell hope for so long, but man, they've done a great job of it so far. Here's the other thing that people wonder. I don't know if many of you want to say it out loud. Subconsciously, this is what worries you, though. Subconsciously, when it comes to rival fans of Tennessee, what worries you really is you're looking around and you're seeing Jeremy Pruitt put together a top 15 class and a top 10 class. Let's just say they finished 7th or 6th this recruiting cycle, and they have sold nothing but hope. There's been no product on the field they've been able to sell. What you think in your heart of hearts is, this Pruitt guy, if he just pulled this off with these kinds of records and this little production and that barren a trophy case, if he's done this with that, what happens when they start winning a few? What happens when they're a contender in the SEC East? What happens when Tennessee football matters outside of Knoxville, Tennessee and the like into November and mid-November and late November, and God forbid they ever actually slip up and get to Atlanta, play for an SEC championship? A lot of you want to stifle Tennessee. A lot of you want to stifle the growth before it really becomes a nuisance for you. I understand. If I was a Georgia fan, I'd feel the same way. It's nice to just be able to thump them away like a pesky gnat every year. It's nice to run off that string like you've run off as a Florida Gator fan. That's nice. I just think that it's borrowed time right now. Not telling you they're about to run off a string against you, but I am telling you, as many reasons as you have to be pessimistic about this, I think there are as many, if not more, reasons to be very optimistic about the run that Tennessee football could be set to go on. Just become a contender. If nothing more, that upsets a lot of what is current in the SEC East.